First of all, though, a couple of years ago, defender Peter Haddock was named Supporters Club Player of the Year, but for him, this campaign has been even better.
I think there's no comparison, really. This has been sort of the best season of my career, really. I didn't expect to be in a team at the start of the season, and I got in, and I thought I'm going to make the most of it, sort of thing. And things have worked out great. All the lads have really done well this season, and we've finished up champions.
Is this your best season in terms of playing style?
Yeah, it's got to be, I think, yeah. I know I got player of the year a couple of years ago, but, I mean, you know, we just finished just off the playoffs then, and it wasn't a really good season. But, I mean, this season, everything has gone great. I've played reasonably well all season, and we've finished up champions. So, yeah, I've got to say this has got to be my best season.
What's there been a difference this season, apart from the obvious turn in results, between the other seasons where Leeds have been less successful?
I think more quality players, really. I think the manager's brought in a lot of quality players, and I think, like, we've all gelled together, sort of thing, in a reasonably short time. And, it's proved it on winning the championship, really.
Maybe the slow start of the season, in some respects, was due to the, like you said, the difficulty it is getting organised early on, but Howard Wilkinson's really made you gel into a team very, very quickly, as was shown by your astonishing rise at the table midway through the season.
Yeah, like I say, we didn't have a too good pre-season, really, as well, but we worked at things and that, and, like, we started off and we had a bad result at Newcastle, a few draws, but, I mean, we won 16 games undefeated about... When was it, October time, sort of that, and, you know, I think we went on top of the league in November, and I think we've deserved to stay in there, really, ever since then.
Maybe the only thing that was missing for you was a goal. Are you hoping to get a goal eventually for Leeds?
Well, I've got one 2 years ago, but, I mean, I'm not a really good goal scorer. All I do is stay in the halfway line, try and stop other people scoring, but I would love to score a goal, yeah. Hopefully it could be next season in the First Division.
Maybe at Anfield on the first day, perhaps?
Oh, I would love it, yeah.
Well, just 18 months ago, Mike Whitlow was playing non-league football with Witton Albion. Now he's won a second division championship medal, an unbelievable transformation.
It is really, it's quite a shock. It hasn't sunk in properly yet. The lads have done very well. Chrissy Fairclough, Gordon, Peter Haddock, all of them really have deserved everything that they've got. I enjoyed the majority of the first half of the season. Fortunately, I missed the second half through injury, but I've enjoyed every minute of it, and a championship medal's more than you can believe, really.
Especially considering where you were just over a year ago.
Most definitely, HFS League now, and now a second division championship medal. It'll be taken home and cherished very much so. I've got the shirt, and Mervyn gave me his undershirt, being I didn't get a shirt from Saturday. I got it all signed, and that'll be put away too for years to come, to cherish more than likely.
What do you remember most about what's been a very memorable season?
To be fair, the start of the season I didn't expect to be playing, so I remember enough most of the games that I've played in. It sounds silly, but you remember the most of them. And Bournemouth Saturday, sat on the bench watching the lads. Unbelievable. When the goal went in, the relief, and then Aire in the middles were scoring. Brilliant after a long hard slog they've had, especially Gordon. Brilliant leader. So it's been good.
What was the highlight maybe for you? Another goal?
The highlight more than anything was scoring and getting in the team more than anything at the start. I missed the first game at Newcastle. Unfortunately, I got my chance the game after and took it from there. So it's just each game, really. I've enjoyed every bit of it. So I can't really point out one game. But it was nice to score away at Portsmouth early on in the season. So I've enjoyed most of it, and the lads have been great, and we've had a good time now.
Well, it's not just the players, of course, but a whole club effort. Physio Alan Sutton has played his part too. He's also delighted with success.
Well, obviously, the high point is winning the championship. I think, to be fair, I experienced it probably when I won Halifax Rugby League, when I won it against all the odds. And afterwards, I don't know, I can just feel totally drained for days. And obviously, with this season, we're no exception, because towards the end, it does start passing through your mind whether you haven't been going to the playoffs. But I mean, all credit to the lads. When it really came to the nitty gritty, and it really came to the crunches in the crunch matches, they came up better than probably any other team in the league, and I think rightly so.
Now, you're on the bench every week. What's it like sitting next to Mickey Hennigan, who seems to never sit still, and Howard Wilkinson? What's he like in the last few minutes when he comes down to the bench usually?
Oh, I mean, the manager, Mick, I mean, I don't really think about it now. I mean, I've probably got so used to him. And everybody, even Mick, by his own admission, he's the craziest man on the bench. But you know, I mean, the thing is about the Tuchels, they're so honest about everything, the way they think and how they do everything. I just purely get on that bench to do what job I have to do, because I've got to be on that pitch as soon as any injuries and make sure that I've concentrated 90 minutes and get my own job sorted out.
Quite a lot of injuries for you this season to keep an eye on as well.
To say that we've actually ended up winning a championship with the amount of injuries we have, I think goes a lot, a big way toward maybe what the squad we have got at the club. Because, you know, coming back on the coach, you know, it just did get mentioned that the lads who have come in, like John McClellan, being brought in for, you know, Peter Haddock, like the Sheffield United and Brighton game, you know, at the end of the day, you get 4 points, you know, out of them two games. And that, again, had been a big factor, I think, towards, you know, us getting the championship. And obviously the other lads have come in, you know, the standard squad what the manager's managed to get together. And to say they've been out for so long is a great credit really to the manager of the team.
The novice Sheffield, where they couldn't report a single fail. The Leeds United song is out and it has a catchy title. Definitely a miss, but I think the championship might be on the cards after a song like that.
No one can stop this great white machine.
Famous all white strip.
Rising again like a phoenix from the flame. Runs we drop, we take the knocks and feel no pain.
Exactly 20 minutes to 3 now. I'm Clive Settle, and you're listening to Champions on Air FM.